Hello, good afternoon, students. Today's presentation we are going to see about the numerical reservoir simulation, that is application of flow equations, how we are doing the modeling in reservoir engineering, that is especially numerical reservoir modeling. So here we are going to see for the different equations, application of your Taylor series and separate equations for oil, gas, water separately. It's a module based course. So let's go to the presentation. So numerical reservoir simulation. So here, just I am giving you the introduction first, the course content, just a module based course. So introduction, discretization techniques, finite differences, and differential equations for mass flow, then reservoir equations, water equations, flow terms. Water, flow time for water in the x direction, flow time water in y direction, and flow time for water in z direction, and also the black oil model and well equations for black oil model, then accumulation time for water, then oil equation, then flow time for oil, again flow time for oil in x direction, and flow time for oil in y direction, and flow time for oil in z direction. Then accumulation term for oil, then a gas equation, then flow term for gas, flow term for gas in x direction, and flow term for gas in y direction, then flow term for gas in z direction, then flow term for dissolved gas, then flow term for dissolved gas in x direction, flow term for dissolved gas in y direction, then flow term for dissolved gas in z direction, then accumulation term for gas in dissolved gas, dissolved gas, and we will do the different approximations, first order approximation, second order approximation, and second order approximation of f dash, then different approximation, then discretization error, gridding, faulted reservoir, well locations, then an imposed grid, initial fluid distribution, and your reservoir performance. So this is our basic content of this module based course on numerical reservoir simulation. And also the basics of your standard numerical solutions techniques for all the reservoir flow equations, how we are doing. So this is your introduction. We already learned in my previous presentation in our channel on reservoir modeling simulation. So I also made a video for presentation on your Eclipse and Petrel, etc. And one lecture also I have made for reservoir simulation. So you can see the gridding. So you can see the numerical model. So we'll do the stability analysis, discretization errors, approximation, all the differential equations or mass flow, gridding, reservoir equations, and your reservoir performance. So this is your introduction. And also in our reservoir modeling, also we have learned all these procedures for your modeling. So data equation, sampling, logs, data, cores, check shots and pressure, fluids, etc. So that is your understanding, conception model, then 3D structures, basis model, property model, then fluid distribution, volumetric estimate, and then uncertainty, etc. Then again, go for the structure. So here in this reservoir modeling, so we'll do the seismic interpretation, structural analysis, relative basic tie, depth conversion, AVO, attribute analysis, then sedimentology, petrography, stratigraphy, and correlation. That is for flow zone analysis and petrophysical interpretation, core analysis and rock typing, property trend analysis, etc. Then dynamic data analysis, flow test analysis, so PVT analysis. PVT analysis also, I made one presentation on this channel. Then production history, decline curve analysis, DCA, then material balance. So this is your basic reservoir modeling. But now in this flow equations, how you are doing the numerical solutions analysis techniques. So then discretization techniques. So you are using only the all the mathematics, especially all the differential equations, that is PDE equations, partial differentiation. So the general partial differential equations for reservoir fluids, it must be discrete. You have to do the discretization before it can be go for the computational analysis. So the most common techniques, finite difference FDM methods and finite difference finite element methods. So here we will learn about the finite difference methods. So what are the finite difference techniques in discretization procedure? So first is you have to replace the differential operators by algebraic expressions, number one. Then compute the approximate solution at the given points and the specified times. And third one is the finite difference approximations are used in most commercial reservoir simulation softwares in order to solve your flow equations numerically. So you learned a lot of softwares, you know, already. So there are commercial softwares, Petrel, Eclipse, and others. Reservoir simulation softwares, commercial. So we do the FD, finite difference approximations. So now let's go to the differential equations for mass flow. This is the first equation. So you can see for water, oil, and gas. So you can read the equations. So what are the parameters? So you have the formation, volume factor, then viscosity, pressure, density, and your Q, that is your black oil model, mass conservation equation for, and V is your porosity, then for water, same. So you can see here in for water, oil, gas, so there is a dou by dou T with respect to water saturation divided by BW, that is formation volume factor for water. So similarly for oil, partial differential dou by dou T phi into S0 by B0 for oil, similarly for gas. So what are the parameters? You can read the equations. So pressure difference delta P, W for water, then you'll see the viscosity, then other parameters, water saturation, then gas saturation SG, and B0 for formation, volume factor for oil. Then we are doing again the dou by dou T change in your water saturation, formation volume factor for gas with respect to your time, that is dou T. So these are the other QJ, QR, sink and source terms for mass conservation. So what are the parameters? So here porosity, then we are using the waterfall formation, water saturation and formation volume factor, etc. Then discrete equation for black oil models for different blocks. So in the discretization, we are doing the IJK for black models, black oil models for different blocks. So for water, same. For oil, for gas. So delta T for water, then dou phi plus Q of water IJK equal to in terms of delta. So we are multiplying change in water saturation with formation volume factor BW for water, similarly for oil and similarly for gas. But in gas, so we are adding the phi SG by VG plus phi RS S naught plus B naught. So one term we added in the for gas. So this is your discrete equations for black oil models for the different blocks IJK. So you have to understand the volume delta T, temperature difference or time, etc. Then other reservoir parameters. So this is your reservoir equations. So the water equation, how will you define the water equation? So the water equation will consist of three parts, that is your flow term, well term and your accumulation term. Therefore, flow term plus well term equal to your accumulation term. So we are writing the water, this equation, delta T W plus delta phi by W plus Q for water at IJK equal to V by delta T into delta T multiplied by SW by W into phi. So this is for water. So the flow time water consists of three terms, so one for each coordinate direction. So for X, Y, Z. So this is for water. Then, so the flow time water in X direction. So you are writing for the X part consists of two terms. So one is to compute the flow to neighbor block in the positive direction and the other flow in the negative direction. So negative is shown as minus. So for water, you can see this equation. Delta X T of WX into delta X into phi W equal to, you can see the one flow in the negative direction. In the bracket, you can see that is minus, same one we have done the for the negative direction. One for the flow in the negative, you can see the equation clearly. Then flow term for Y direction. Similarly, the Y part consists of two terms. One is to compute the flow to your neighbor block in the positive direction. The other one for flow in the negative direction. Similarly, for the flow term for water in Z direction. So the Z part consists of two terms. The one is to compute the flow to neighbor block in the positive direction and the one flow, one for the flow in the negative direction. So delta Z, T, WZ, delta Z and phi W equal to this equation, that is one in the positive direction and the one for flow in the negative direction. So this is the Z part consists of calculating the water in Z direction. Then well term for water. Then well equations for black oil model. So this is for water, QWI equal to WI multiplied by K or W divided by MW BW multiplied by the PI initial minus P well. Then the WI, I equal to 2 pi KH into divided by logarithmic of Re by Rw plus S. P is, well is the pressure in the well. So this is the well equations for black oil model. Then, so you can see the terms clearly. K N W, then mu W, B W, B P I minus P. So P W well equal to P is the pressure in the well, that is denoted by P well. Then well equations for black oil model, that is oil Q O I equal to W I water index multiplied by the K R naught divided by V naught B naught of I multiplied by P I minus P well. So you are getting the W I equal to 2 pi K H divided by L N R E divided by R W plus your S. So this is also one well equation for black oil model. Then this also same, another one well equations for black oil model. So Q G I equal to W I W K etc. So here the parameters are viscosity, formation value factor of gas, etc. Then pressure difference PI minus P well. So these are the parameters utilized. So WI equal to 2 pi KH divided by LN REW by R plus your S. P equal to pressure in the well. Then accumulation term for water. So the change of mortar in the block IJK during the time delta T between the step N and N plus 1 is given by this following equation, that is IJK y IJK into divided by T into delta T into phi into SW by BW, which gives this equation for accumulation term for water. Then this is the oil equation. So what is oil equation? So the oil equation consists of three plot: flow term, well term, and accumulation term. So I for oil, delta T O multiplied by delta phi zero O plus Q of oil, that is IJK coordinates. So this is the oil equation: flow term, well term, then accumulated term. Then flow term for oil. So flow term for oil consists of three terms, one for each coordinate direction. So delta x tox and delta x phi ox, similarly for y, then similarly for oz. Then flow term for oil in x direction. So the x part consists of two terms. One is to compute the flow to neighbor block and the positive direction, and the one for flow in the negative direction. So this is the equation. Then, so this is for oil. So the y part consists of two terms. One to compute the flow in the regular to neighbor block in the positive direction, and one flow in the negative direction. So next is for z direction. So the z part consists of two terms, one to compute the flow to the neighbor block in the positive direction, and one for flow in the negative direction. So this is the equation employed for oil. Then L term for oil, then accumulation term for oil. So the change of mass of water in block IJK during the term delta T between the step n plus n1 is given by the following equation. So oil VIJK divided by delta T into multiplied by T into S naught divided by B naught into pi. So this is the accumulation term for oil. So the gasification consisting of flow term for gas and dissolved gas and well term and an accumulation term for gas and dissolved gas. So therefore flow term for well term equal to accumulation terms. Then the term for gas consists of three terms, one for each coordinate system. So this is the equation. So this is shown very clearly, x, y, z, product of delta A, delta T and delta x into phi gx, similarly for gy and gz. So then flow term for gas in x direction. So you can see the equation. So it consists of x part, two terms, one complete flow to neighbor block in the positive direction and one for flow in the negative direction. So same parameters. So additionally one, what has been added is your so flow term for gas in x direction, then flow term for gas in y direction. So the y part, what is consist of two terms. So one is to compute flow to neighbor block in the positive direction and the one flow for negative direction. So this is 22. Then flow term for gas in z direction. So the x part consists of two terms. Once to compute the flow to neighbor block in the positive direction and then one for flow in the negative direction. So this is a concept of gas flow in z direction. Then flow term for dissolved gas consists of three terms, so one for each coordinate direction. Then next one. So this is the dissolved flow term gas in y direction. So the y part consists of two terms. The one is to compute the flow to neighbor block and the positive direction, and one is the flow in the negative direction. So dissolved gas equal to there is delta T, delta Y, RTS, TY, then delta Y, then gamma oil. So you are getting this equation. Then flow term for dissolved gas in the Z direction. So the Z part consists of two terms. So one is to computer flow to the near block and the one in for the flow in the negative direction. Then next one, accumulation term for gas and dissolved gas, that is change of mass of water in the block IJK during the time delta T between the step n and n plus 1 is given by for the gas VIJK delta T into multiple delta T is the product of pi RS by RS0 divided by BO then for gas. Then, so the equation for gas same, you can see the equations. So all the formation volume factor of oil, gas, etc., porosity and change in time and volume. Then different approximations by Taylor series. So for different approximations, the Taylor series are used to derive the different formula for single and double derivatives. It is Taylor series f of x plus delta x and f of function of x minus delta x are given by these formulas. Then so this is your difference approximation. So you are applying the Taylor series f of x plus delta x equal to fx plus f dash x delta x plus 1 by 2 factorial into f 2 dash into delta x the whole square plus 1 by k factorial into f ki delta x into x. So this is your Taylor series for x plus delta x, and second is x f of x minus delta x. So function of x minus delta is equal to f of x minus f dash x delta x plus 1 by 2 factorial into f2 dash multiplied by x into 2x squared plus 1 by k factorial f k into delta x x into delta x. So with these equations we can also do the first order approximations, second order approximations and second order approximations of f2 dash, f dash and f5. So now let's go to the second approximations of then first order approximation of pi. So you can see here the Taylor series expansion f delta x plus delta x, you can get the expression for f dash x. Similarly, from the expansion of f of x minus delta x, we can get the expression of f dash x. So this difference formula is used for discretizing time derivative in the mass equations. You can see here the difference formula. So that is first order approximants point at ut. This point n plus 1 is given by this equation un plus 1 minus u2 dash divided by delta t, and the time axis is given into points at the distance of delta t. You can see here n t and n plus 1 t plus delta t. So first order approximation of f dash from the series. So we have to add f of delta x plus x from series of delta f of x minus delta x. So the step size reduction products produces more accurate approximation. That is first order expression of f dash. Then second order expression of f2 dash. So here expansion of x plus double delta x and x minus delta x results are in the approximation shown. So a delta x x, you can see the Taylor series. So the sum of the f dash x of the series and f of x plus s and f of x minus delta x is very clearly shown. You can see the diagram. So this is really the size of modern, or you can say that for more accurate approximations. Then second order approximation of f2 dash. So you started using already Taylor series. or you can say the second approximation up to the sum of the Taylor series f of x plus delta x and f of x minus delta x is used to reduce the second approximation of f2 dash. Then next is, so this is your second order approximations. So the sum of the Taylor series f of x plus delta x and f of x minus x is used to deduce a second order approximation of f2 dash. That is, we can see here f of x is a function of f of x plus x minus 2 f of x plus 2 of function of x plus delta x plus o in delta x squared. So this approximation is frequently used in the numerator, and it is written as in the form delta squared f equal to f of x minus delta x minus 2 f x plus f of function of x plus delta x. So this is the approximation of function of second order. So next is difference approximation concept. So here you can see the ux can be approximated at each point by the formula u xx equal to ui minus 1 minus 2 ui plus ui plus 1 divided by delta x squared. You can see the point x, that is I, then x plus delta x I plus 1, then x minus delta x, that is I minus 1. So this is a difference approximation. Then there is a discretization error in the Taylor series or Taylor's expansion. So this analysis of Taylor expansion. So the discretization showing the error very faster for high order approximation than for low order approximation. You can see here for both errors. Then you are gridding. So your gridding, faulted reservoir, well locations, imposed grid, and your initial fluid distribution, etc. Faulted reservoir, so well locations, and imposed grid, and initial fluid distribution. Then this is your faulted reservoir. Then well locations are shown, produced well 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, etc. And then injected well also shown here. Then an imposed grid. So main criteria for grid selection is that the ability to identify saturations and pressures at specific locations, and planned well locations also, and the ability to produce solution with the required accuracy, then the ability to represent geometry, geology, and physical properties of the reservoir, boundaries, faults, permeability, distribution, including the vertical layering. So then that is your imposed grid. Then, so this is your initial fluid distribution in your reservoir. So the one inch in the red color is the gas, one inch is your green is your oil, then blue is your water. So initial fluid distribution are shown here, and the stable and unstable results are shown here. And for stable solutions, delta T by delta x squared is going to be 0.4 from the diagram of this graph. That is stable. Then unstable solution, so you can see the unstable delta T by delta x squared equal to 0.6 for unstable solutions. And this is your reservoir performance. So you can see the reservoir performance. The one inch is your oil is your green, then water saturated, that is in the blue color, and then red color is a gas, saturated gases. So this is a reservoir performance. So we have learned today the basic equations. Thank you. So we have completed our presentation today on numerical reservoir simulation with the different models, that is for X, Y, Z directions, that is in your preferred locations or different well locations. And also we have listened the Taylor expansion series, which is also utilized in this modeling. And also you learned some discretization techniques. So thank you. We'll see more on numerical reservoir simulation in our channel in future lectures. Thank you.